I chose to lead the Department of Human-Centered Computing because I'm enthusiastic about technology and digital technology, but I really care about people. Human-centered computing brings those two things together.
So I found a program at Monash that combined tech and art, which was basically this practice-based PhD we do at Sensilab.
We've got interaction designers, we've got artists, we've got a real multidisciplinary mix of people.
The lab's organised across five programmes of research, which look at future health, energy futures, mobility's futures, and the future of work and learning.
We've collaborated with the HCC department for about 2 years, and it's primarily focused on how you might use innovative digital methods that could engage a much broader group of young people across our network.
But our projects also encompass a whole range of quite exciting emerging technologies, things like artificial intelligence and automated decision making. We're also interested in technologies like digital voice assistants and other smart home technologies.
So it's not just researching and not just programming, which I did a lot of, but it was also writing, modelling and fabrication of things. So it was a really wide range of things that I was able to develop my skills at, which was really great.
What has been different here in HCC is this very, very deep level of creativity and energy to do something as well. A lot of the individuals are just very passionate about trying to make a difference through their work.
During my time at Sensilab, I developed my first artwork called Mirror Ritual. I was able to basically extend beyond that kind of academic university sphere and kind of have my work shown in exhibitions and stuff, so it engaged like other types of people as well.
We work with a wide variety of partners, industry, government, not-for-profits.
Working with those organisations, we enabled us to do interdisciplinary research.
When you're talking about artwork, like, you want to see how people react. And I guess I had no idea at the beginning what the response would be.
It needs to be a willingness to create and be innovative and to try things you haven't tried before. Increasingly, a lot of organisations are working like that. And if that's the case, then this is exactly the kind of partnership that can be mutually beneficial.
If you've got a problem that you think we might be able to help you with, well, we'd really like to hear from you.
Working with Monash University has given me the opportunity to work in a world-class institution.
It's an opportunity to bring in new ways of thinking and new insights, and you know that is something that's irreplaceable.
The support from my supervisors has been really amazing. I feel like at every point I was encouraged to just follow my interests and kind of produce the work that I wanted to do and follow the research that I was interested in.
I'm really proud to work in my department because of the people. I just come in every day and something remarkable has happened.
It's just fun. It's like a really cool, like fun. Everyone's just really passionate. Everyone's really excited about what they're doing.
It's a very can-do kind of attitude. It's a very practical, focused one.
People who are committed to doing research with technology for social good.